Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Microsoft's Java for Beginners series. My name is Brian Benz, and I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft. In this topic, we're going to talk about string concepts. We're going to go over chars and how to pronounce that, strings, string arrays, and some of the new methods that are in newer versions of Java for handling strings. So let's get started. Today, we're going to talk about char and string. You can say car, chair, care. These are all acceptable pronunciations. I use car. We're going to talk about commonly used string methods, and I'm going to share some of my favorites with you and ones you're going to run into most. We'll show you how to implement string arrays, array lists, and then wrap up with a little bit of information on naming Java variables, which is always good to know. Char is a primitive data type. That means that the variable is actually stored as a value directly in the variable and not referenced as an object, as is the case with many things in Java. You're going to run into other primitive data types as well, which have the same behavior, including Boolean, byte, short, int, long, float, and double. Remember that char is spelled with a capitalization of a lower case C, not an uppercase C. Java is case sensitive, and you need to make sure you start it with a lowercase c. The char data type can store any letter numbers between 0 and 65,535, and any 16-bit Unicode character, including special characters. The value for a char is always enclosed in single quotes. And there's an object wrapper called character for a char data type that you might want to use in certain situations. Here's a few examples. The first line is assigning a variable of primitive data type char with a name of ch and a value of j. The next line is assigning a primitive data type char to a variable named unicar, but it's in this case using the Unicode reference instead of the actual letter. And here's a char array. The array is in curly braces. Each value in the array is delimited by single quotes and each value separated by commas. Methods you need to know about when you're working with char: is letter, is this a letter? Remember, it's a single value. So is this single value a letter? Is it a digit? Is it white space? Neither a letter nor a digit nor a special character. Is it uppercase or lowercase? You can also convert it to lowercase or uppercase using two uppercase and two lowercase. And you return it to, you can actually convert it to string, which returns a string object and leads nicely into our next topic, which is strings. Strings, unlike char, are not a primitive data type. They are a provided class in Java. It's string with an uppercase S, not a lowercase s, the opposite of char. String in any other class, as I mentioned, is a reference to an object. Values for string are enclosed in double quotes. They can be stored in arrays, which are also considered objects. Strings are made up of an array of chars. So I showed you before how you actually assign a string, a char array. This is how you actually, behind the scenes, write a string. So Java actually uses a char array to store a single string object. Because strings are objects, they're immutable. They can't be changed once created. You can use string buffer and string builder classes to provide mutable string functionality. And I'm going to show you some methods as well that will do similar things, allow you to set up some things. And you can also use the I'll show you some other things you can do with that as well. So assigning variables with string, string S, the name of the variable is S, the value is J. String with the square brackets indicates a array, in this case named string array, and it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are the values inside that array, delimited by commas, each value delimited by double quotes. Here's some commonly used string methods. Java 8 methods Where is a value inside a string? It's going to return an int starting at zero. All values, when you talk about indexes or parsing anything in strings, starts at zero. Int compare is going to compare one string to another. String concat, so you can take string one, string two, and create string three. Remember, they're immutable, so you can't edit the strings, but you can add them together and create a new string. Int hash code, it'll create a hash code of type int from the string. You can check the position of a particular letter in a string using index of. You can check the length of a string using length. You can do a replace function. When you do the replace function, once again, you have to create a new string with the replaced values in it, or the new values in it. you can also do a split. The split will create a new array with the split values in it from the original string. You can say, you can check to see if a string starts with a certain character using starts with. You can create a substring of the string using substring. You can convert things to lowercase or uppercase using two lowercase and two uppercase. And trim removes any leading or trailing blanks in your string. As of Java 11, there's some other things you need to know about. Is blank checks to see if there's any readable characters in a string, even if the index of the string or the length of the string is greater than zero. That might not be something that's readable, so is blank will tell you if that's the case. Lines returns a stream containing a collection of all substrings split by lines. Strip removes all white spaces. So it doesn't, unlike trim up here, strip will actually remove all white space from strings, and it is Unicode aware. Repeat creates a new string with a value of the original string repeated int number of times. Java 13. Java 13 has some cool stuff. Text blocks improve the readability of string literals when representing a multi-line string. Text blocks, as of this time, Java 17 and 18 is still a preview feature, but it is a great feature to use and take advantage of. If you create a text block using three double quotes at the beginning and the end of your text block, basically, the formatting inside that text block will be honored, including new lines and other things. If you look at the original way to do this with string literal formatting, it's really hard to read and really hard to follow. String arrays. Every main method in Java has a string array declaration. So I just want to share that with you because it's something you're probably already familiar with. When you say public static void main to create a main method, you pass arguments, which become parameters using a string array. String arrays can contain multiple string elements, also called tokens. They're referred to via their corresponding index number, int, starting at zero. Array lists are good to know about. Array lists are... You import Java util ArrayList into your class, and ArrayLists are a way to actually create a array that can have values added and removed to it easily without having to create a new array out of an old one. So you can actually use your existing array, add and remove values to it. It's very handy to know and very handy to use. There's some unique syntax when you're setting it up. You say array list and angle bracket string, and then the name of this particular array list is flexible list. That's something you determine. And then it uses a constructor to say new array list, and then the type for the array list is going to be string in this case. So that's actually how you set up an array list, and from there you can add and remove elements and or tokens to that array list anytime you want. And you can convert it to a string array later if you need to. Naming Java variables. Let's wrap up with this. It's very important and it applies to all variables. All variable names will start with letter, underscore, dollar sign. The first letter cannot be a number. You can use a number in your name, but it can't be the first character in your variable name. And Java has reserved words which cannot be used. You can search those. They're out there. There's quite a few of them. But you also, in your IDE, if it's any good, will tell you if you're using a reserved word when you try to use it.
Okay, so that's string concepts. Please check out the rest of the topics in Microsoft's Java for Beginners series.